Well, we're just shy of 30 minutes from the latest Reserve Bank decision. Rates are expected to remain on hold. Mortgage holders may need to wait a while longer for rates relief. State and federal government spending is poised to comprise a record 28% of GDP by the end of 2025. That's according to fresh Westpac research, and that could further delay a rate cut. Live to Political Editor Andrew Clennell. So, Andrew, one of the areas of federal spending tipped to grow is a greater childcare subsidy, amongst other things.
Yes, and it looks like they're pretty firm on that, Tom. So a very interesting day, as it is these days, since the Reserve Bank governor's been required to give press conferences. The last one in August, she said that they were looked at a rate hike. Surely that won't be the case now, or will it? Will they still have the jitters, the Reserve Bank, in terms of potentially even contemplating a hike? That'll be one of the questions in there when we telecast that press conference. It almost feels like things are happening in reverse because we get the monthly inflation number. It's expected to be substantially lower, maybe even within the target band tomorrow. Having said that, I expect Michelle Bullock to get another question in terms of, is that just because of the cost of living measures by the federal and Queensland governments? Things like electricity bill relief. Is it a bit of a mirage? So all of this is ahead of you on Afternoon Agenda. I had Jim Chalmers, the Treasurer, on Sunday Agenda, and he said the reason that we're not looking at a rate cut and places like the US and other countries are doing it is simply because their rates were lifted higher. They have higher to come down from.
Even with that 50 basis point interest rate cut in the US, their interest rates are still higher than in Australia. They went up by more. Inflation was higher, their interest rates went up by more, and even after this interest rate cut, they're still higher. That's true in the UK as well. And so when we compare ourselves to these other countries, we've got to make a full comparison. You know, some of these countries that our opponents like to bandy about, Canada, the UK, New Zealand, you know, some of them have got higher unemployment, they've got higher interest rates, many of them went up by more over the last couple of years, and so you need to make that full comparison.
And we'll hear from the Treasurer from Toowoomba this afternoon as well. Well, Tom mentioned that childcare subsidy. It's guaranteed to happen, the Treasurer basically said. They're subsidising the NDIS more, aged care more. Soon it's going to be childcare. At what point do taxpayers say, why are we subsidising everything in this economy? And that those Westpac figures came out today showing before the pandemic, government spending in the economy was 22%, now it's 28%. This is the contest at the next election, or one of the significant contests. Energy is another one, obviously. Shadow Treasurer Angus Taylor, you'll hear him at his press conference, again reinforced this point he's been saying for 2 years. The government's spending too much. Well, Jim Chalmers indicated they're going to continue to spend when it comes to childcare subsidy. With a big policy for the next election, we know the opposition in response is planning a tax cuts promise. As Treasurer, do you see what the Productivity Commission is asking for in terms of a bigger childcare subsidy affordable?
Well, as Treasurer, I'm a very, very big supporter of early childhood education. We've already made enormous investments in making early childhood education cheaper. We're paying educators what they deserve for the first time in a long time. We do understand that we need to get a bit closer to a system that looks like it's universal. But we need to do that in a responsible way, a methodical way, an affordable way. None of this is cheap.
All right, so we'll talk to you later on in the hour. We'll have the decision, Andrew, and then later on today we'll hear from the RBA. You know, what do they make of government spending? I'm sure Michelle Bullock will be pressed on that. On the question of Lebanon and this ratcheting up of this conflict, some earnest warnings again. These are not the first ones, are they, from the government around Australian citizens leaving Lebanon while you can, because commercial flights, the airport itself, could be targeted down the track, not the flights, but the airport.
Yeah, it's getting pretty serious, and obviously, you know, stability in the region, in the world, and indeed in the economy could be affected by this becoming a broader scale conflict. We've got Penny Wong, the Foreign Minister, over at the UN General Assembly, warning about this, hoping for a de-escalation. Not much sign of that at the moment. But the Prime Minister in Perth today, I know what you're saying, Tom. They've been warning every day, especially the past few days, get out of Lebanon, and indeed over the past few months. This is the most impassioned plea he's given so far. He says, even while we've been giving these warnings, Australians are still going to Lebanon. They're still not coming back from Lebanon. well, now's the time. Get the hell out of there.
The fact that some people have continued to go from Australia to Lebanon in recent months is not a common sense thing to do. The government issues these warnings for a reason. And the advice is that people should take the opportunity to come home on commercial aircraft while it is available.
All right, so that's stark warning, as I said. We'll talk to you later on in this hour, Andrew, once we have that decision from the RBA.